Most every non-legendary Pokémon is able to breed and produce eggs, but the most glaring exception to this rule is Nidoqueen and Nidorina. All three of the Nidoking stages and female Nidoran are able to reproduce, so why can't Nidoqueen and Nidorina? If these Pokémon were all real organisms, I think this can be explained by reproductive senescence and the grandmother hypothesis. Senescence is essentially just aging, and almost all organisms age. Even Pokemon age as evidenced by old Treecko, this old Hoothoot, or Tracy's old and grizzled Scyther. Reproductive senescence refers to the decrease in fertility or fecundity as an organism ages. In animals, this is best known in humans, orcas, short-finned pilot whales, and maybe some non-human primates, but it may be more widespread than previously thought. In organisms that go through reproductive senescence, or in humans, menopause, females of this species will lose their ability to reproduce in the later stages of their life, which is somewhat similar to Nidoran losing the ability to breed once it evolves into Nidorina or Nidoqueen. Now, evolutionary stage doesn't always equate to having an older age. Like, old Treecko can be an older age than a Sceptile even though it's in its first evolutionary form. But it is much easier for older, more experienced Pokémon to be in those later evolutionary stages than the younger and more inexperienced Pokémon that are usually in the early stages. But if all organisms age, why do only some go through reproductive senescence? Like, most organisms can reproduce throughout their entire life stage, so why do only some lose this ability? Well, for most organisms, it just isn't worth it to live past your ability to reproduce. The whole point of most organisms' life is to live and produce offspring and pass on your genetics to the next generation. So if you can't reproduce, you usually aren't any use to your reproductive line any longer, and age catches up to you and you perish. The difference with these species is that they can help the continuation of their genetic line even after they lose their ability to reproduce. And this is where the grandmother hypothesis comes into play, and I think this perfectly explains Nidoqueen's reproductive senescence. The grandmother hypothesis states that as a mother ages, the cost of reproducing becomes greater, and energy would be better spent on helping their offspring raise their young rather than to reproduce themselves. Grandmothers assisting with the care of their grandchildren help ensure the survival of their genes in the younger generations. And the continuation of an organism's genetics is really the only thing that evolution cares about. So if we assume that most Nidorina and Nidoqueen are older than most Nidoran, they might have an increased cost to reproducing, and this would favor the older individuals and the more advanced evolutions, helping the younger Nidoran and their offspring. We also see through Nidoqueen's stats and Pokedex entries that they become much stronger after evolving. This may help Nidoqueens secure resources for their Nidoran offspring and associated family groups, which would contribute to a wider group fitness. This allows Nidoran to solely focus on producing eggs and taking care of the immediate needs of their young. Oh, and gives them time to find competitive Nidoking to reproduce. Because Nidoking don't experience reproductive senescence and are able to reproduce in every stage of their evolutionary line. This parallels the males of most species that don't experience reproductive senescence or experience a much less drastic decrease in their reproductive ability when compared to females. Nidoking and males of most animal species retain their ability to reproduce because females are the only ones burdened with that high energy cost of producing eggs or fetuses, and the male production of sperm has a much lower energy cost, and their involvement in raising young is also less intense, if they're even involved at all. That's why this is called the grandmother hypothesis and not the grandfather hypothesis. Or maybe we can call this the Nidoqueen hypothesis? In actuality, this probably arose as a programming error output in the second generation of Pokemon games, and others have hypothesized that Nidoqueen can't reproduce because they parallel the difficulties that humans have had in getting certain rhino species to reproduce in captivity. And these are great hypotheses. I know these would have come up in the comments if I didn't mention them. I've seen them, they work great, I enjoy them. But I think this is a great example to explain reproductive senescence in Pokemon by using Nidoqueen as a model. But we'll never know the true answer to these hypotheses without more data. So get out there and observe some Nidoran reproduction in the wild, you freaky little scientists.